For this step, you should have your center back seam sewn and also the shoulder seams. I also added the clear elastic in the back of my shoulder seam. And you should also have your neck binding cutted out on the greatest stretch of your fabric. And do follow your pattern piece because it is shorter than your neckline. And be careful to cut it on the greatest stretch of your fabric because it needs to stretch to be able to sew it around your neckline. The next step is to quarter your neckline, and to do that you are going to bring these points to the center back like so, and then you have one quarter on this, so two quarters, and here the same. You bring this corner to the center back and you have here another one. The same you need to do with your neck binding. You do it first in half, like so, put a pin on it here, and then bring the two ends to the pin in the center, and then you have the other two quarters. The next step is very easy actually. In the instructions, you will read that you need to fold this in two, like so. And then sew it right side, sew it on the right side of your neckline with a 6 mm seam allowance, and then turn it. I'm going to pin it for a moment. So something like that, of course, stretching it a little bit. Let's say that this is sewing, and then you need to turn it to the inside all the way, so you should not have any binding visible at the end, like this, and then stitch it next to the fold, so you have a very very clean inside. That is correct, but in my case I'm using this this velvet, and I think it's going to be a lot of bulk there. So to make it thinner there, I'm going to attach it like this, single layer. So I'm going to match these two points, and then I'm going to match the the marks we made, the quarters. So I have here one, you can see already that is pulling it a little bit because the binding is shorter. So right sides together, sew it on the right side of the fabric, and then the next one is going to be here at the center back, and so on. So at this moment I am at the sewing machine. I just lowered the presser foot tension a little bit, that is not pressing too much on my fabric to stretch it too much out, because I want to control myself the stretching of the fabric. So I'm using also a quarter inch presser foot to make it easier to see where the 6 mm seam allowance is, but of course you can use your standard sewing foot. So I'm going to start sewing. I'll take one or two stitches before I start to stretch. As you can see here, my binding is here without pulling anything, and my garment is here. So my binding needs to stretch a little bit to meet with my neckline. And this is what I'm going to do also. I'm using a regular straight stitch. It's very important that you are stretching only the binding and not your neckline. So the binding is attached, as you can see, it tends to curl a little bit to the inside, and that is okay because it is stretched. And what I like to do is to give it a little bit of steam all the way around. And the next step, I'm going to do that later, and the next step is to press this to the inside. But because I'm using this velvet, it's really difficult to press it from the right side. So I'm just going to press the seam very carefully towards the binding, like so. It's a little bit difficult to see, like so. This is the seam pressed towards the binding. And I need to feel it with my hand. And then the next step is to you need to be careful that you don't get here, you know, like an ugly fold or something like that. The seam needs to be very nice pressed. Like this, so the seam allowance is pressed up. And then the next step is to turn the binding to the inside, like so. I'm going to put a pin, and then I'm going to show it to you. And try to favor the seam to the inside, and I'm going to show you in a minute what I mean. Of course, the binding is going to be way too wide for this, but that's okay. So the binding is turned now to the inside, and what I meant by favoring the seam to the inside is that you turn just a bit more than the seam where you just attach the binding to the neckline is getting to the inside of your garment. That's making that from the outside, then you don't see this seam. You can see it here, but from the outside you'll see nothing. It's going to be a very nice and finished result, like I have here on the ponte dress. Maybe I can show it to you better. As you can see, this is the inside with the seam, and from the outside I have no seam. If you do this right, you can use even another kind of fabric for the binding, but then you really need to favor the seam that you don't see it from the outside. So the next step on my velvet dress is going to be to top stitch this from the outside. So the next step is to top stitch this from the outside. Here is the binding turned to the inside. And here is the front of the dress with that seam a little bit favored to the inside. Okay, I have here only a small piece prepared. Later I'm going to make the complete neckline, and I'm going to sew it somewhere around maybe 8 millimeters or something from the edge. This is something that you can decide yourself how wide you want to have it. And this is how it is looking from the outside. You can barely see it. And this is from the inside. You can see the stitching line here. And now the next step is going to be, of course, you can give it a little bit of a press, and then you are coming with a scissor. Here you need to be very careful not to snip in your bodice, and then you need to clip just maybe 2 millimeters away from the stitching line. I moved a bit from the sewing machine that I can to have a little bit better lighting. So the idea is that you need to be careful when you snip this, that you are not cutting in your bodice or in your dress, you know. And then you, of course, this is a little bit messy because it's velvet, but this is your edge, and I think it's looking very nice, and it's also almost no bulk here, even if this velvet is pretty fluffy. And this is how I'm binding the neckline on my camellia dress. I hope this video helped you a little bit. If you have any questions, put them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. Happy sewing!